Having a Skriva stylus opens up lots of activities on your iPad, which are great for learning. And one of the examples I've used quite often is the Freeform app on a table of students. So rather than doing a mind map with post-it notes and a big piece of A1 paper, we can do it digitally on Freeform and use that Skriva stylus to handwrite post-it notes as a whole group collaboratively. Here you can see I've got a Freeform board that I've made with a picture of a rocket taking off in the middle, and the instruction to students is to create a mind map of adjectives that describe this scene, perhaps for a piece of creative writing we might do later on. Underneath there, I've got a row of post-it notes, and there's enough there for every student on my particular table. This is for the green table. So all I'm going to do is press the share button in the top right corner, and I'm going to change this to anyone with the link can edit. And that basically means I haven't got to manually add Apple IDs for my students. Instead, I can then take that link and share it straight into Shobi and share it with the exact students I want to receive it. So in my demo class here, I'll send it to a few demo students, but you get the idea. Then, when your students join this document, it's time for them to choose their own post-it note colour. They're simply going to write their name onto one of those colour post-it notes underneath the picture, and then from then on, that's the colour post-it note they can use for the mind map. I find this works really well for classroom management. I can see straight away which students have added which things to the mind map, and it gives them a sense of ownership over their content as well. So now I've chosen my colour, I'm simply going to make a new post-it note, and then change it to the colour I've just chosen. I can then duplicate this a few times to make a few post-it notes all the same colour. And then all I need to do is simply zoom into that post-it note and use my Skriva stylus to write some adjectives on those post-it notes. I'm going to just do one on each one. And then when I've done that, what I want to do is actually group the handwriting to the post-it note itself. So I'm going to use my finger and tap and drag a box over the post-it note. And you'll see it selected not only the post-it, but also the text as well. From here, I can then simply tap onto this button and then choose group. And what that means is that when I move the post-it note around, the writing will also be attached in place to that post-it note, just like it would be in the real world. If you don't group them, the text and the post-it note will go in separate directions, and that's no good. And then I can simply turn on connectors, and I can drag and drop a connector from this post-it note back to the middle of my mind map. And already it's starting to take shape with those post-it notes. But because we invited the whole table in that collaboration earlier, when I zoom out, as if by magic, you'll see their post-it notes appear on the mind map as well. They've chosen the right colours, and their handwriting does look suspiciously like mine, but that's the magic of editing. Hopefully you can see just how easy it is to create a collaborative mind map in Freeform. And me personally, I like to take this learning one step further by getting my students to use a highlighter tool and then just circle two or three of their favourite words from that whole mind map. Very quickly, you can start seeing which words are most popular on the table, and everyone gets an input in that process. And that's just another way that an iPad or a Skriva stylus can augment and enhance the teaching you do in your class.